Over the last decade, UAB has carefully built the necessary infrastructure to build and to grow an incompatible kidney transplant program. That foundation, in combination with the nation's second largest kidney transplant waiting list, a dedicated team of knowledgeable and passionate transplant nurses, physicians, and surgeons, and the altruism and commitment of our living kidney donors, has really set the stage for this historic kidney chain. Today we celebrate not only the nation's longest living kidney chain, but more importantly, the gift of life that has been so graciously been made possible by the altruism of our living donors. 34 donor and 34 recipient lives have changed forever. The unselfish acts of our donors have given our recipients hope and a promise of a future. It began with the one altruistic gift of a woman named Paula Koch, who is gracious enough to join us here today, and has continued by the selfless acts of kindness by many other donors to follow. It has been said that what we have done alone for ourselves dies with us, yet what we do for others through simple acts of selflessness remains immortal. These donors and their recipients are our inspiration, and on behalf of the entire UAB incompatible kidney transplant team, many of whom are sitting here behind me to my left and right, we thank our living donors and recipients for the privilege of being but a small part of the miracles they each are and have helped create. UAB's commitment to excellence and innovation, along with our community's incredible capacity for compassion and willingness to help others, uniquely defines UAB as a leading kidney transplant program in the United States. So thank you very much for being here today to help us celebrate the many miracles that have been created by the selfless kindness of strangers. I'd like to take a minute and introduce one of those living donors who has made this chain possible, Ms. Shelly Gary.
I was thrilled to be a part of this and to be able to give life to my friend Alan Heron, whom was my intended donor, a recipient, instead giving to Thomas Blankenship from Tennessee. I get to see this woman on a regular basis, and I'm very proud to say that I can help her be with her grandchildren and her husband and her daughter and myself a lot longer than we had anticipated. I'm very thankful to all the new family members I've made through this amazing miracle. All of the donors and recipients and their families and friends and all the people that have been changed forever from this amazing gift. Thank you to Jayme Locke and all of your staff for allowing us to be a part of this. I appreciate all the love I get from people who think this is such an amazing thing, and it is, but it was something that I just couldn't think of any other reason why not to share that one gift extra that God gave us. Thank you.
I was diagnosed with polycystic kidneys at the age of 12, so I've known for most of my life that this was coming. I watched my mother suffer with kidney disease and go through dialysis, and I really didn't want to go that route. Fortunately, the program here at UAB made it so that I could get a transplant. It probably would not have been possible with the cadaver kidney because I have high blood antibody levels. The living donor program allowed them to find somebody that was compatible enough where they could do the plasmapheresis treatments on me to make it work. And Dr. Locke and her whole team are just absolutely wonderful. I want to thank Kelly, my ultimate donor, for doing this out of the goodness of her heart. I want to thank my sister-in-law, Laura Abernathy, who donated on my behalf so that I could get one and live a normal life. So thank you very, very much.
It is much faster than waiting for a deceased donor transplant. Depending on your blood group, if you don't have access to a living kidney donor, you can wait anywhere from 5 to 10 years. With a living kidney donor, we're usually able to find you something within a year. And so that's one of the wonderful things about this program, With the incompatible program, what we tell our patients, if you can find someone who's willing to donate on your behalf, we'll figure out a way to get you transplanted, either through one of our paired exchange programs or through a process called desensitization. But it's really opened up the possibility for receiving the gift of life in a much more timely fashion. And we know that the faster we're able to get patients transplanted, and the longer they either avoid dialysis or are able to get off dialysis, we know they have longer life. And that's really our goal.